Naden, ain't good with thanks, but thanks. I owe you.
Ago, they weren't fighting to the death.
I'm in the crap. I gotta get to the green. Already been in the top. Yeah, try to be so much, man.
I heard Skullface never shows his face because it's covered in burn scars.
Runner, a delivery from Astrid awaits you in the canteen.
Delivery? It's gotta be Chiro.
These regular vets are nothing.
Now you should have told us you're that good.
Chiro!
Hey, Aiden.
Yeah, I know, stupid question, but you okay?
Don't I look good? I'm just so fucking tired.
You up for a beer?
Yeah. Please.
Feel better?
No. But I will, after a few more. Thank you for saving me in the arena. Some fucking champ.
It's all over now.
What's over?
Well, you're free.
I know. Astrid picked me to be a fighter.
What?
She even picked me a new name from the Bible. Cain. Cain. Sounds tough and strong.
Oh, seriously? Astrid made a deal to let you go.
And she did.
So why are you here, Chiro?
Call me Cain. Same reason you are.
Listen, Chiro. Your father and me risked our lives to free you.
My father? So he sent you here.
Yeah, he's waiting for you outside.
You asshole. Thought we were friends.
That's why I did it. God, you spoiled shit.
No, that's why my father got you to make me lose. Fuck you both.
Things got complicated.
Shit, guards gonna hear us. Wait for you outside.
no one. Good day to you, stranger. You fight in the arenas, don't you? What is it that you seek there?
This is a crooked place, and I gotta win to bring justice.
And if you lose?
I won't.
I have trained many true champions. The path to greatness is a long journey of triumphs, but also defeats. It was no different with the current champion.
So you trained Skullface?
I trained he who hides behind the mask. I showed him the path. I set him on his way to the top to become a true champion. But he uses his skills and knowledge to commit foul acts.
Where'd you get this mask?
I made it. This was supposed to be the symbol of a true champion. I planned to give it to Skullface, but he chose the wrong path. He got his own mask, and this one is waiting for its true owner.
Teach me what you taught Skullface.
I could, but you must be gifted, as Skullface was. Only then can we start such training. And he was my most talented student. I understand you've faced the trials Skullface mastered, but you have not yet proven yourself. If you hope to face Skullface and survive, you must master all three trials, breaking all of Skullface's records. Only then will you be on the path of greatness that leads to the finale.
Okay. I'll return after I finish the trials.
I hope you come back very soon.
So where's Chiro?
Listen, Ogar. He wants to keep fighting.
Stupid bastard. That's it. No more kid gloves. He needs his ass kicked before he gets killed.
They'll kill you.
Or they won't.
You can't help him dead.
Good point. I still want him out.
There might be another way. Could leave on his own.
The hell do you mean?
Look, I mean, I'll beat Skullface. Chiro wants him. If Skullface loses, Chiro can't lose.
Some plan. Kill Skullface. Except you can't. No offense, Aiden.
Got a better idea then?
No. Find my old dressing room. I buried my armor and the weapon there.
Do I need rusty armor and old weapons?
Only if you want to beat Skullface. I won the tournament with that gear.
Yeah, thanks, Ogar, but I need an upgrade.
You need to listen, boy. You're a goddamn jumper, not a fighter. Tetsuo crafted this gear for me especially. Tell him it's old and rusty. Now find my room and report back.
Look, no offense, Ogar, but... Okay, I'll think about it. Okay, where's that armor? Ogar, I'm in your room.
Okay, tell me what you see.
Ugh, looks like he's a Skullface fan. The new guy has some nice armor himself. You sure that wouldn't do?
No. Mine was special. Believe me, that shit's aluminum foil compared to my gear.
Wow, a tiger skin rug. Living large, Ogar.
Well, at least I know you're in the right place. Stash the armor behind the rug.
Hey! Hey, you! What the hell are you doing here?
Calm down. Yeah, I just came for an autograph.
An autograph? Why didn't you just say so?
Well, I am now.
Nice. So, what's your name, pal?
Aiden.
Aiden. Nice. Wait a minute. You're that piece of shit pilgrim. I heard of you. You ain't here for no autograph. Come here! I'll crush you. Fuck! Okay, stop!
I wasn't looking for trouble. Just this armor.
Don't know what the fuck you're talking about.
Empty.
How the fuck did that get there?
Don't bullshit me. You took the armor.
Don't know what you're talking about. Ain't touched that thing since I've been here. Thought it looked nice. A legend used to live here, you know. Ogar. Wait, you're looking for his armor? Thought he gambled away everything he had.
You know where the armor could be.
You think I'd be using that pile of scrap if I did? Man, if I'd even thought it was here.
Clearly it wasn't. I guess I'd better go. I found your hiding spot. It's empty.
Not so good with secrets. I was drunk when I told her.
Yuan?
Yeah, last time I saw her, she worked as a craftmaster in Carnage Hall. Unless she gave up on that too.
It won't hurt to check her out, will it?
Might change your mind when you meet her.
Are we trying to get into a night of terrorists?
What, you want it?
Hey, you're Yuan, right?
What's it to ya?
Well, I'm looking for a friend's fighting gear. He says he told you where he hid it.
Don't know what you're yapping about. Are you crafting something or what?
It was Ogar's armor. Yeah, remember him?
Ogar? Don't tell me that idiot wants to fight again. Hasn't he lost enough? Oh, I know. He wants to lay it down on a bet. Don't step in Ogar's shit, kid. It don't wash off that easy.
Look, if you have it, I can pay.
I don't. Sold it to Freddy Stammer a long time ago.
Who?
Freddy Stammer. As a fighter, he was always number two. Just like his shit personality. Till he finally said the wrong thing to the wrong person and they booted him.
So you and Ogar, were you close?
Define close. We met when he commissioned his armor. Let's just say, we forged more than his breastplate.
Why'd you break it off?
The more Ogar won, the more out of control he became. It was hard to watch.
Out of control?
Just take my advice. Steer clear of him. You'll live longer. And if you plan on fighting, don't let the arena swallow you, like it did Ogar.
Where can I find this Stammer guy?
He lives by the electrical substation in Old Villador. But good luck getting it from him.
Come check out what I've got.
You look like a man who knows what he wants. Stay well supplied by shopping here.
Wanna check out my merch? I may have found your armor. It's with some guy named Freddy.
Enjoy your time at Carnage Hall.
Freddy Stammer. Yeah, I remember him. He was an okay fighter.
You have quite the reputation, you know.
As a fallen champion.
As a gambling addict.
Just get my gear, okay? Unless you want Skullface to dismember you in 2 seconds.
Gear so fine! Ain't seen this stuff anywhere else, right? Keep ranking up and happy.
Hey, teach me some moves. I don't want to be a guard for
all the real gladiators are gone.
Thank you. Definitely the best honey in Villain.
You a beekeeper or a brewer?
I'm both. That's the secret of my double bark. You must have noticed most beer in this town tastes like piss.
Well, you're not wrong.
That's exactly what I'm talking about. Nobody cares about taste anymore.
Does that surprise you?
The truth is, so-called brewers nowadays are damn amateurs.
And you're a pro, I gather.
You bet. And it's an excellent time for my trade. Demand for beer is higher than ever. Brewers are in the top 10 most stable jobs in this city.
Right after the Undertakers?
Right. Nice one. As for me, I'm dedicated to nurturing my yeast and my bees.
Your bees?
Yup. You know what the secret ingredient is to brewing the best beer in town? Besides love, of course.
I'm guessing you're about to tell me.
Honey. And to harvest the best kind of honey, you need the best fed bees. Speaking of which, maybe you could help me with my bees. Feed them some sugar? I have my own special beehives in the area. Put them up high to keep them out of reach of those who steal my honey.
I can try. Where exactly are these beehives?
First, you need to find the bags of sugar I've left nearby to feed them. If you find the bags, you'll find the beehives. There are three of them, all close to each other. The first one is on a rooftop just nearby. If you look towards the main terminal, you can see it from here. The second is on the rooftop of the main terminal building, below this big tower covered with a peacekeeper's banner. And the third one is on the top of the main terminal station, just beside one of the statues. Please do it quickly. Business is so brisk, I've neglected them lately. Oh, they're probably starving. I guess I'm
more of a brewer than a beekeeper after all. Oh, a bag of sugar. I can save Barak's bees from starvation.
when we're on a
Nobody? Ever again? That sounds a bit extreme.
Well, you think so? What do you think is the first step in loving yourself?
Are you some kind of spiritual guru trying to recruit me?
Oh, no, please. I'm very down to earth. Hanging around near the metro station in considerable safety and all. But I used to be a florist down in Trinity. I had a shop there, the Blooming Tulip, near the bazaar, when it was still the Church of the Holy Trinity. I was raised in an orphanage among a multitude of apathetic people. Maybe that's why I turned to flowers. But after the outbreak, people stopped buying them.
That's understandable.
Certainly, but there was this old lady. I basically kept the store open just for her. She'd come every day, as if nothing had changed. Her visits were the highlight of my day, until one day she didn't show.
I mean, you didn't expect it to last forever, did you?
Maybe I did. I was growing these special pink roses for her. It was her last order, and I simply couldn't throw them all away. So I kept one of the roses and dried it, just for her.
She'd be delighted to know that you never forgot her.
Yeah. If only I could get that rose to her. Could you take it? She never said where she lived precisely, but I asked her once where she kept all her flowers. She said, in a beautiful house made of glass, where the old mound used to be. Here, take the rose. Please find the house and give it to her, if she's still there.
Thank you. Who's that? Go away.
Looking for Freddy Stamma?
Why? What do you want?
Listen, I'm not here to hurt you. I'm just looking for some armor. I was told you had it.
Armor? What the hell are you talking about?
Ogar's armor?
Ogar.
Yuan the Craftmaster told me you bought it.
Oh, Ogar. Ogar. Yes. Yes, I bought it. To keep it safe for him. But that was some time ago. Did Ogar send you?
Yeah. He wanted to loan me his armor for the tournament.
Interesting. Good old Ogar. Yeah. Knew he'd want it back one day. He always had better stuff than us. That armor made him a greater champion than he already was. Wait here. I stored it in the basement. Let me get the key.
Good times. Me and Ogar. Fights between us would sell out Carnage Hall. Rivals in the arena. Best friends outside of it.
Oh, really?
No more fighters like us now. Not at all. Ah, here's the key. Take it. I'd escort you down to the basement, but I can't even navigate the stairs with these eyes.
Wow. He really was a great fighter. Why isn't he showing these off? Seems like Freddy was a Carnage Hall celebrity. What?
Where are you? Defend yourself! Should have been him, not you, Abel. I would have won this time.
Who's Abel? Why do you keep calling me that?
Quit playing. No one else could have kept up with me. And they trained you well. He knew they would.
Tell me, Abel. How did that feel? You were his poker chip. Fucking bet on his pride.
What are you talking about?
But Astrid got him. Hit him where it hurt the most. I've always pitied you, boy, for having that shit as a father.
So Ogar bet his son's life?
Gambling is a drug. And Ogar, the fucking junkie. Oh, he lost big that day. Junkie. Loser.
afraid of what happens in the Knights of Terror.
Glad I didn't lose as badly as you did.
Well, that's better than losing your hands like you did last month.
If you cut yourself to pieces and bent your own leg, it would be good.
No wonder you have so many fans. I know about Abel.
Abel?
Yeah, your son. The one whose life you gambled away. Was it worth it? Does Chiro know?
I didn't just lose a son that day. See? This was Abel. He was everything to me. He was just one more bet before I took my boys and left the arena behind.
So, what happened?
I was at the top. Best of the best. Had prestige, fame, money. But all good things come to an end, right? Astrid told me to throw the last fight. Pass the title to some fresh meat she was cultivating. Lose the third round, she ordered. That meat was Skullface. We fought one, two rounds. The crowd was mine. I knew it. They chanted my name. Hearing that makes victory so sweet. I was a champion after all. Astrid didn't know that I'd placed a bet. Everything I had on myself. To pay the pilgrim that could take us from the city, I waited till the third round and won. I knew she would go after me and my sons. We ran! But her dogs, they caught us. She forced me to hand over one of my sons. To become a Carnage Hall gladiator. Chiro or Abel? Chiro or Abel? If I didn't, she would kill them both.
So you chose Abel?
Chiro was no fighter, but Abel, I trained him. He was fast, strong, but Skullface was too much for him. He was after vengeance, blood. I sent my own son to his death. I should have protected him, but I lost him. All the line in my pockets. I gave up. I had nothing to live for. But Chiro kept me going. Even though I didn't deserve it. I am a failure of a father. And he stayed anyway.
Listen. You lost Abel. But it's not too late for Chiro. You can sit here and complain, or we can still help him.
You're right. It's my last chance to make things right. I'll find my way in, and his way out, I promise. Until I do, go. Stay safe. Keep an eye on him, please.
Sure, I will.
Go, Aiden. I have to figure out what to do next.
That was good. We should have nights of terror every day. I mean, every night.